Hi everyone. In the past few videos, we have been talking about spline interpolation, and the varying degree of complexity we can add to improve our interpolation results. In particular, we are going to now talk about how we can implement these three spline interpolation methods that we've been talking about in the past couple videos into Python, those being linear splines, quadratic splines, and cubic splines. To demonstrate spline interpolation, let's begin with a simple dataset. Here we have a list of x and y values representing some points on a graph. To do this, we are first going to import all of our necessary Python libraries. These libraries are going to be matplotlib, scipy, and numpy. To import these libraries into PyCharm, which is the IDE that I'm using in this video, we're going to click on our interpreter in the bottom right corner of our screen, and then click Interpreter Settings. Making sure you have the correct interpreter selected at the top here, we can now go down to this plus sign at the bottom of our window. This button is going to add packages to our Python interpreter. So, within this window, we are just going to search for all three required packages and add them to our interpreter so that we can begin playing with splines within Python. Now, back to our main Python file, we can import our downloaded packages. Then, let's just go ahead and create a simple 1D array of values that we want to interpolate. In our linear interpolation example, we use this set of data, so I'm just going to reuse this now. To visualize our data, we are going to use matplotlib. To begin, let's just create a simple scatterplot of our data. To do this, let's call our matplotlib function like so, and tell it we want to plot our x and y data points. Now, if we run our file, it'll give us a line graph, but that's not what we want right now. We said that we wanted to plot a scatterplot. To do this, we just add a circle marker to our data points like so, with a label denoted that these are our data points. Lastly, I'm just going to add a legend to our plot like so. Now, when we run the program again, we can see that we have just created our scatter plot, which is exactly what we wanted. To create a linear interpolation between these data points, we need to create two variables. Firstly, we need to create another set of x data points that will be plotted along with our interpolated y values. One way of doing this is through the numpy lin space function, which takes a starting value, an ending value, and then a number of equally spaced intervals between those two previous values. As we can only interpolate between our lowest x value and our highest x value, I'm going to use the numpy min and max function such that our x interp variable fluctuates with our data entry. Then, let's just arbitrarily select 50 intervals. Now, let's make a one-dimensional linear spline interpolation through these data points. To do this, we'll make a new variable called y_linear. Then we'll call our 1D scipy interpolation function like so, and tell it that we want to interpolate our data set. Now, let's just add in another plot like so. And we'll give it a color, so let's make it red. Lastly, we'll just add a label denoting it as our linear interpolation. Running our file again, we can see that we have now interpolated our data with linear splines. Just briefly, if you wish to use the interpolating function to find the output of any given input along your domain, all you need to do is call our y_linear variable and give it an input like so. Running the file, you can see that we are printed the output. This allows you to easily call the function and use it however you need. Much the same way, we can implement one-dimensional interpolation using quadratics and cubics. Let's first show how to do this with quadratics. Let's make a new variable called yquadratic. Then we will just copy our linear code from earlier. And all we need to do here is add a statement of kind at the end. Tell SciPy that we want our kind of interpolating function to be quadratic in nature. Then we add another plot like we just did for the linear interpolation. Running our program, you can now see that we have successfully implemented a quadratic interpolation. One thing to note here is if we do not have enough intervals in our x direction on x interp, then our quadratic spline will not look smooth. This does not change anything about the y quadratic object, it's just visually how matplotlib can interpret and present the data to you. Lastly, let's talk about cubics, the most common form of interpolation. I'm just going to go through the exact same process that we just did with the quadratic splines. We'll add a new variable called yCubic and set our kind to cubic. Then we'll add another plot like we did with the past two interpolation methods. Running our program, you can now see that we have successfully implemented a cubic interpolation. One thing to note here though is that we cannot manipulate boundary conditions through this method. We will need to use something like the cubic spline function. So let's show how that works now. Let's add that function to our import. Then I'm going to call the cubic spline function and add a boundary condition of natural as we learned about in our previous cubic spline interpolation theory video. Then we'll add the plot line of code and call it cubic spline BC for boundary condition. After we run this file, you can see that the cubic spline seems to fit much more appropriately using this natural boundary condition. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how you can implement and use one-dimensional spline interpolation within Python. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.